Haben dir auch schon mal Gedanken?
Have you ever wondered which nutrients are essential for plant growth? Plants absorb nutrients from the soil. In this video, we'll take a closer look at potassium, which is one of these important nutrients. My name is Sabrina Schwind. I'm the product manager for sensors at Metrum. Today I'm going to show you how to determine the potassium concentration in soil using the standard addition method. Soil is a fairly complex matrix. This is why standard addition is the preferred method. Standard addition has several advantages over photometry, for example. The instrumentation is simple, and the chemicals used are both harmless and easy to obtain. Therefore, almost anyone can carry out a standard addition.
Dementsprechend kann es praktisch von jeder Person durchgeführt werden. Um eine Standardaddition durchzuführen,
here's what you need to perform a standard addition: an ion meter, a stirrer, a burette, which doses a standard solution, and most importantly, an electrode to measure the potential. Also, you need an ionic strength adjuster. This is a solution with a high ionic concentration, which fixes the ionic strength of the sample. To be able to optimally dose minerals for crops, it's important to know what's already present in the soil. That's why we take samples directly from the field, preferably from different locations, and take them to the lab to dry and then analyze. To determine the ions in the soil, they must first be extracted. To do this, we add an extraction solution to the dried, sieved, and ground sample. This releases the potassium ions,
wo dann die Ionen, die man will bestimmen, in dem Fall Kalium, freisetzen. Nachdem wir die Bodenprobe mit
After stirring the soil sample with the extraction solution for 2 hours and filtering it, it's ready for the ion measurement. We take an aliquot of the sample and add 2 milliliters of the ionic strength adjuster to it. Then we add a certain amount of the deionized water and place the sample on the stir plate. The electrode is immersed and the start potential is measured. Then we add a potassium standard until a potential difference of 15 millivolts is reached. We do this 4 times in total. The software then automatically calculates the potassium concentration of the sample. The measurement takes just a few minutes. You can find more information on the determination of potassium by standard addition in the application finder on our website. Simply search for AB134. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a like and feel free to share it.